All right, hey guys, I got a special treat for you guys today. I just recently acquired vinyl GP MCP, and I think the M stands for Modular Command Post. It is an 11 by 11 current production military tent. This tent is dated 2010, so it's fairly new production. This tent is a Velcro and buckle system. So all the walls Velcro and buckle to one another, and it has adjusting guide ropes here. As you can see, this one has a stove. I put this tent up last week, and it was just me and my dad, and the instruction manuals that came with the tent that was actually printed on the side of one of the bags weren't exactly all that clear how this went up, so we kind of just figured out if anybody has a link in the proper way or wherever all these go, just please send me the link. I'd like to learn how. This tent is capable of blackout, meaning that once all the enclosures are buttoned down and that no light is supposed to escape this. So not as to give your position away to the enemy. I guess that was the original designation of this. As for me, I'm using this as a mobile deer camp, mobile bug out tent, someplace that I can live that I don't have to take a RV to or try to squeeze that through the woods. I could probably much better, me and my friends could get this in there and we could have a place to live that would keep us out of the rain and cold. So far, I'm pretty impressed with this thing. I'm just going to give you a little synopsis of where I got this. I got this out of General Jim's in Clare, Michigan, and I paid around $695 for this without tax, and the stove in it was extra, and it came with a lot of parts that I seen that other tents didn't come with. It has the floor, it has the liner, had all the poles. The only thing that it didn't have was the stake. It even has the rain gutter. The cool thing about these modular systems is that you can hook more than one tent together to increase your space. And the rain gutter provides rain protection in between the hookups of the tent, which I kind of think is awesome. That front part right there that says US is a vent that's open all the time. And there's also one in the back. Like I said, I don't know if I did a perfect job with setting this up, but let's go ahead and check out the inside. As part of the blackout feature, this has two enclosed, one in the front and one on the tent. So there's an entrance way. So if you're in blackout mode, you step in, you close this door behind you, and then you enter that other door. Therefore, you don't let any light escape. And believe it or not, it's also pretty good at keeping the heat in. I thought about maybe draping a couple wool blankets over the ledge that's in there just to kind of when I'm really in the cold camping or something in order to try to keep the heat out or the heat in, excuse me. So here's inside the tent. Here's the three bags that it comes in. There's a large pull bag in the back. And then here's the liner, and the floor is also on the bottom, the gray thing. And here's the rain gutter. Now, surprisingly, this tent was in pretty good condition. Like I said, I got this out of General Gems for $695, and this was the used. And they also had a like new for $895. Now, when I bought this tent, I expected to have some minor repairs to this. And besides a few small little pinholes that you see right there, this tent is in perfect condition. I mean, there's no wear. I expected some cracks to be in the plex, the little plastic windows. That didn't happen either. So all in all, for my money, I'm really impressed with this tent and the quality of it. I'm glad I didn't pay the $895 to get the like new tent. It has an internal frame system, which you guys can kind of check out right here. It also has guidelines and wires that you can hang lanterns or whatever. This tent, when it was originally issued, came with map boards and electric lights that were supposed to be in it. When I bought this, it did not include that, and it didn't bother me any because I'll just rig my own system up and I really don't need the map boards for anything. I'm pretty impressed with this. It's pretty nice tent. And it is a Four Seasons tent, so it doesn't have to be used just in the winter time. You can use it in the summer, spring, fall, winter, whatever you want. And I also bought this stove separately, which is an H35 model. I also bought the spark arrestor just so I could burn pine in that, and I didn't have to worry about my chimney catching on fire. My next purchase for the stove was going to be a chimney thermometer. I had a little trouble hooking the flue up, but I finally got it in. The flue works fine. And that stove is hot. Hot, hot, hot. And it works great. I love it. I think this is, you know, if you're a prepper and you have a little bit of extra money and you don't want to spend money on an RV, I'd like to put this up a few more times to see how it actually works and functions first to make sure I get it all right. But if you don't want to spend money on an RV, I think less than $1,000, you could have a mobile getaway. And it's dual purpose too. You could use this as a deer camp. You could use this as a bug out location. You could use this as whatever the heck you wanted to. The cool thing about this too is that you can take the front wall and the back wall off of the side walls or whatever you want to do, and you can park a car under this. So it's also can be a garage to keep your car out of the winter if you want to do that. I've seen them used like that before. It can be as a mobile workstation, a garage, or anything like that. Here's Axel. And it's 2010. So I'm loving this purchase, guys. If you guys know anything about these, so you know where I can find the actual manual that shows where everything's supposed to go and how it's supposed to be hooked up, could you please link that? Any comments or questions, feel free to ask. I'd be more than happy to answer them. But I'm loving this tent, and my stove needs more wood. Full review to come on the stove next. Thanks. Bye.